You take the blue pill. The story ends. You wake up in your bed and believe whatever you want to believe. You take the red pill. You stay in Wonderland. And I show you how deep the rabbit hole goes. Remember, all I'm offering is the truth, nothing more.
Lives don't matter if you vote for Democrats. Black lives don't matter if you vote for Democrats. Move the fuck out of my way. Black lives don't matter if you vote for Democrats. We're tired of you white liberals always doing some fuck shit. Move out of our way. You guys don't care. You guys, you can start what you want. I don't give a fuck. I said what the fuck I said. Move the fuck out of my way. My kids are in this car. I want to go home. If you care about black lives, stop fucking voting for Democrats. You care about black lives, stop fucking voting for Democrats.
Come on, I'll give them
you racist white liberals do this shit every fucking 4 years. We're tired of it. We're tired of it. Stop acting like you fucking care about us. You care about us, then take your ass to the abortion clinic. Tell us about killing their fucking babies. No, fuck you, you dumb bitch. You're not here for me. You're here because you're dumb as fuck.
I would be in the same position you're in, so I'm not even mad at you, baby.
I don't want like any news because it's
a fake news. This is the thing. I know people don't like Trump. I understand that. But let me tell you something. If I had to pick between him and Joe Biden, I'm not voting for Joe Biden. You want to see a bunch of black people go to jail by the next 4 years? Put Joe Biden to life. Watch what happens. You want to see black men get killed substantially? Like you've never seen before, put Joe Biden in and watch what happens. These Democrats, and I'm sorry to say this, I'm not trying to be racist, but they hate black people. These are the same people who fought to keep slavery in. These are the same people who built the KKK. These are the same people who hated us from the beginning. The Republican Party is the party of the blacks. Blacks free, the Republican Party is the only party that the black people actually assisted in finding. But all of that history has been torn away. People say, oh, there was this big switch. There was never a big switch. The union won because we had grown in the industrial era. So we were able to get trains and get supplies back to our soldiers while the Confederate was still riding horses. They were not able to get the supplies back fast enough, right? So what happened was once slavery was abolished in the South, the people in the South could no longer make their money from slaves. They had to move to the North to work in the industry to produce. And so the people in the North that already had established themselves in the industry moved to the South. And so that's where it was a transfer of people coming from the South to the North and people coming from the North to the South. There was never a big switch. So the same Democrats who hated black people from the beginning are the same ones who hate us now. And they use our cause. How did Black Lives Matter turn into something about LGBTQ when blacks really don't support that? We're conservative about that. We really not about that. Not only that, we don't support abortion. We're about workers. This is the black culture. We ain't even been about that. Not only that, we not about feminism.
No, we're not.
Black women marry their husbands and respect their husbands. That's what we on. We not on this, I do what I want. We don't do that. That's not our community, and you would understand. I know you understand what I'm saying. We don't do that. But yet these people are hijacking our movement, and the Democratic Party, they're trying to hijack our stuff. No.
Let's talk about Roe v. Wade and how there have been millions and millions of black babies killed, and Barack Obama supports that. Why aren't we talking about that?
It's always been this time.
They don't respect you.
Someone was in the slave house cooking for the master.
And someone
in the slave house. I'm going to talk about the pregnant women. They had to jump off the slave ship when they bought them here.
Okay, but let's talk about Democrats support black genocide. Let's talk about that. Let's talk about the fact that they don't want educational choice for poor black kids in the inner city. And we're coming over here to protest when our people are dying.
I tutor poor black kids out the
top. I'm a school counselor. I work in the inner city. And I support this movement.
And teach.
You know why? Because they don't believe that black babies in the womb have civil rights. We're 12% of the population, but 44% of abortion.
Babies have you adopted? How many
of you adopted? What's your point?
How many of them do you adopt?
I believe babies born in the womb have civil rights, and you
nonsense.
Don't. Oh, they don't have civil rights? You want black babies dead? You think it's okay? We're 12% of the population.
You are a hypocrite. You are a hypocrite.
Glenn Beck didn't want them dead.
I'm a hypocrite?
If you think Glenn Beck doesn't want them dead, you sure
don't. I don't want them to come out and be in poverty.
You would say
But you do.
You don't want them to come out and be in poverty, so kill them.
You just care for them until they are there. After they are out of there, you don't care.
You don't make any sense.
I do.
You want black people dead, so shut up. Why are they walking away when I bring up the real issues? LBJ's war on poverty policies broke apart the black family. Why aren't they talking about that? That's the reason why I became a conservative. When I found out that in 1960, over 80% of black kids were born in two-parent households. After welfare, I work in the inner city. I work with kids that look like me. After LBJ's welfare policies in the 60s, in the inner cities, over 90% of kids are born without fathers. Because the liberal establishment wants to break apart the nuclear family. Because they want kids controlled by the state. That's what Karl Marx said. So let's talk about that. Why are they walking away when I bring up the real issues? Why are they walking away? They can't tell me anything about conservative racism because there's a whole bunch of racist stuff on their side. And then they pretend like all of this racism is coming from the right. Guess what? Republicans and conservatives don't run the inner cities in America. Democrats and liberals do, so why are there still problems? Why aren't they holding the people who are in office accountable? Hold them accountable.